away from home. And then one day we said, nope, we're not doing that anymore because we want to play gigs that matter, not gigs that, you know, put money in the bank. Because if it was about money, we wouldn't be the same people, you know? But now we spend about 150 days on the road, I guess, and that's still a lot. But it's just enough to make me feel like I'm not a piece of shit husband. Doing my part, bring on the baby.
Hey, you got gold. You got gold.
But my wife's been our manager with the ragweed in this band. She's been my manager for 20 years and been my wife for 20 years. When I first met her, we had a record that was in the can, as they call it. It was called Carney. It was our first record. And she said, what's the deal? How come this record's not out? I said, we're broke. We don't have any money. You know, we're all 21 years old, and we make $500 a night, and we save $300 out to buy weed and beer. We need a manager. And a broke either. It's a joke.
It's a joke. You're right.
But she said, let me take care of everything that you guys do. I'll be your manager. I want you to write songs, have fun, and make people smile. And I'll do the rest of it. And I said, I'll be your manager. She said, yeah. But as everything, we had their ups and downs. And this was a very low moment for me and my bride. And I wrote an entire record once upon a time about how everything sucked between this little group. And then she doesn't like the record. And then the other day I told her, I said, I got this tune that's really heavy on my mind. Because we had that fight the day we were in, I was in Stephenville, Texas, and we had a big fight. And she said, honestly, it's been 20 years, and I really don't give a shit what you like out of me. And that's why I love her.